Bunny Striker Lee gone but not forgotten, the Angel OnlyFans saga, pregnancy rumors, and lots more. I'm your host, Alicia, and welcome to Entertainment Recap. The legendary producer Edward Bunny Striker Lee Sr. passed away on Tuesday, October 6, between 1 and 2 p.m. after suffering heart failure at an undisclosed hospital in the corporate area. He was 79. Bunny Striker Lee was diabetic and had a number of ailments. He had been hospitalized for 6 weeks, then was discharged for 4 days, and then the family had to make an emergency run back to the hospital with Mr. Lee. Lee was one of the most seminal figures in reggae music. Lee would be one of the first producers to realize the potential of reusing the same rhythm tracks time and time again with different singers and DJs, partly out of necessity. The latter half of the 1970s saw Lee working with some of Jamaica's top new talents, including Linval Thompson, Leroy Smart, and Barry Brown. Lee began his career working as a record plugger for Duke Reed's Treasure Isle label in 1962. Later, he would produce hits with names like Lester Sterling, Stranger Cole, Derek Morgan, Slim Smith, and The Uniques, My Conversation, Pat Kelly, and The Sensations. He is known for the classic hits such as Slim Smith, Everybody Needs Love, Max Romeo's Wet Dream, Delroy Wilson, Better Must Come, Eric Donaldson's Cheerio Baby, and John Holt's Stick By Me. Rest in peace, Lee. Beanie Man said the Angel didn't need to join OnlyFans and she should have thought about their son marketing before doing so. He responded with these words, "I can't tell her to think about our youth. She's supposed to do that as a mother." But on the other hand, dancehall artist D'Angel will continue to ignore the critics, including her former partner, Beanie Man, as she continues her OnlyFans journey. In an interview Beanie Man did for a YouTube channel, the self-proclaimed king of dancehall openly criticized D'Angel for joining the adult-oriented platform, claiming that she should have considered their teenage son marketing before joining the OnlyFans platform. While she hasn't mentioned Beanie Man's name, D'Angel shared her song, "Am I? Una love me make me prosper. What some I uno I watch for. My sexiness, I wed them after. Hashtag Am I?" Using few words from the song, she urged people to leave her alone on her Instagram. D'Angel also shared videos of her vibing to the song while it was being played on the radio in her Instagram story. She later shared the YouTube link for the song as well as the link to her OnlyFans page. Well, let her will be done. Female dancehall star Chenille Muir had fans guessing if she's pregnant or not? Let's see. The assumptions began when she shared a bathroom selfie with the caption, "Couldn't hold it in any longer." Praying hands emoji. The post has since been deleted. While some fans expressed sentiments of congratulations to the dancehall artist, others were not quite convinced. The singer posted a live video in an effort to quell the rumors, basically stating that body shaming is widely accepted now due to social media and we should accept who we are no matter the size or shape. I'm with that one, Chenille. The queen of dancehall, Spice, has launched her new clothing line dubbed Gracie Noir. Spice has been involved in the fashion industry for a number of years. she opened her clothing store in Jamaica known as Spicy Couture. Now the queen has decided to shift things a bit and take her next venture up a notch by making it a straight e-commerce business. Her brand, Gracie Noir, can be broken down into two. Gracie, meaning grace, her name, and Noir, which is the French word for black. This stands true to her message of black empowerment. You go, Spice! Jamaican Twitter bash L.A. Lewis for saying COVID-19 isn't real as he participates in an anti-mask protest. Even as the World Health Organization has reported over 36 million cases of the deadly coronavirus, with more than a million deaths worldwide, controversial dancehall artist L.A. Lewis has joined some of the maroon population of Jamaica who believe that the deadly virus is not real. The same group, called Nyankopong, also believes that wearing masks is not necessary and is detrimental to one's health. Lewis, their Secretary of State, joined protesters on October 6th in St. Catherine, Jamaica, and told the media to stop tell lie. He accused the media of being part of a conspiracy to make COVID-19 seem real. He accused Jamaican Prime Minister, the Most Honorable Andrew Holness, of paying off the media to do the dirty work of spreading rumors about what was described as a common flu. Then this real? Lewis also warns that the managers of various media houses around the world could face sanctions because they were breaching human rights by saying that the coronavirus is real. His warning extended to teachers who he claimed were paid to lock down schools in January and said they could go to jail for killing children by exposing them to 5G networks. In Jamaica, please note that in Jamaica, more than 7,000 cases of the virus have been recorded with at least 120 deaths so far. Numbers don't lie. This week's new music comes from Quig. Yes, voicemail Craig changed his name to Quig with Just Stop and TJ with Big Drip. Take a look.
So trouble never set like red. Never pay attention and now things change. Missy said no, you
are Missy Richard and the true man. Me a walk the road with blood in a me two hands. See them a wonder where they youth from.
Birthday shout outs. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, these people. Happy birthday to you. Yes, happy birthday to Beanie Man and Crystal Tomlinson, baby girl, TJ, and happy anniversary to Tesson and our hubby. Continue being you and big up who? You. Recap, I'm your girl, Alicia. Follow us on all socials at PBC Jamaica. Just remember, always and forever, big up to you. Have a great weekend.